Dave Rubin, host of the Rubin Report, he's raising a few eyebrows because he had previous support of Donald Trump, but you never really know where this is gonna go now. He was speaking with Megyn Kelly about the potential run for Donald Trump in 2024 to take back the White House. And he had a couple of pointed words for him when she was asking about these poll numbers and how Donald Trump was running away with the potential primary that we would see if it was held today. First, let's listen to what he would have been telling Donald Trump to do instead of running for president again. Let's listen.
Oh, it's Trump's party, and that poll actually does not shock me. Who can still bring out the rallies? Who does the base still love? Who is still fighting the machine, even though he's not on social media and he's just got these silly press releases and everything else? It's still Trump. What I would prefer to happen is that Trump acts as the advocate, keep doing the rallies, keep fighting the media, keep doing all the dirty work, be the bodyguard so that, say, a DeSantis Tim Scott ticket maybe could get through. Let DeSantis, who I think is 43 years old, he's done an incredible job in Florida, he's willing to fight, but let Trump do the dirty work, let him take the hits from the media, let him draw the people to the rallies and go be the statesman, DeSantis. I know Florida wouldn't be happy to potentially lose him.
That doesn't sound like Trump. That doesn't sound
like Trump. No, it doesn't sound. I know, so hey, Don, if you watch Megyn Kelly's show, and I have no doubt that you do, my personal message to you is think about putting your ego in check for the first time in your life. Not because you're not right about a lot of this stuff, but because for the health of the country and for a true healing, not the way Biden said healing.
He went on about Biden, so that's why I stopped it there. But the idea, oh my God, check your ego, Donald Trump. Check it. So, I mean, so hey, these are directed pointed words. And I think maybe that's when the conversation decided to shift, because maybe that's how he really feels. Because no one tells Donald Trump to check his ego, first of all. But also, we may try to think of some of the motivations behind this. We know a lot of Republicans, a lot of conservatives are tired of the way Donald Trump goes about things. Didn't like how he went about it as president. And he mentioned some of that too as well. But also, a couple days ago, Trump also sent out that directive to his people to not vote in 22 or 24 unless we get this thing figured out, which again is discouraging Republicans from voting. More Republicans are probably disappointed in that. And I'm gonna go to one more clip from a big time Republican donor, and that's where the money is. The money always talks. Let's see what this is Ken Griffin, and he was speaking about how he feels about Donald Trump running again in 24.
Would you support Donald Trump if he runs again for president in 2024?
I think it's time for America to move on. The 4 years under President Trump were so pointlessly divisive, it was not constructive for our country. And I never actually financially supported the president. He called my office, or not he, but one of his fundraisers did, one of his very senior fundraisers who I knew. And I opened with, I grew up in South Florida. And I found it incredibly offensive, his attacks on the Hispanic community. Because in South Florida, when you grow up there, those are the people that build your houses. They serve your food at restaurants. And they were my teammates on the soccer field. And I was so appalled by his willingness to play identity politics that I was never willing to support him. Now, his economic policies, by and large, were pretty damn good for America. But his willingness to attack people on the basis of where they came from or their color of their skin was completely inappropriate. And we need to put that chapter in American history behind us.
Chapter in American history behind us. Check your ego, Donald Trump. Sit on the sidelines. Be the security guards. Where is this going?
Yeah, so if you're wondering what in the world is going on, so why does anybody even know or care about Dave Rubin? Because he's got three angles that he plays, right? I'm gay, but if you ever insult gay people, you bring me on your show and I pardon you. Okay, he just did that just yesterday on Newsmax. And one of the other guys on there used the F word about gay people, and he said the yeah. Okay, the smaller one is if you're anti-Semitic, he'll probably let you off the hook on that too, but they don't go to that very often. Because they just, the right wing plays identity politics. Mm-hmm. So they need somebody from each race and ethnicity, etc., to come on and say, oh no, you can say anything you want about us. Great, where's my check? Okay, now, but the third one is, well, I used to be on the Young Turks, I used to be progressive, I used to be a Democrat, and I'll tell you, you guys are right wingers. Oh, these Democrats are the worst, right? I know, I voted for Kerry and Obama, okay? Back when I was getting a paycheck from TYT, I don't know when he was lying. I don't know if he was lying here, if he's lying now, it doesn't really matter. He has no moral core, right? So that's his job. So then why he supported Trump completely, bragged about how he voted for him in 2020, the so-called Democrat. Classical liberal or whatever the hell he calls himself, whatever scam he's running. So why is he saying this about Trump now? That's a good question. Now here's the answer. In the right-wing circles, there are different folks who make money in different ways. So for example, as far as I can tell, I don't know their internal workings, but what you can see publicly in the reporting on them, it looks like Steven Crowder makes money in a normal way. He has a popular YouTube channel. I don't like it. I don't agree with it, but it's popular and he makes money through ads, etc. That like everybody else does, right? On the other hand, Dennis Prager is funded almost completely by right-wing billionaires. So there's reporting on that. He gets $20 to $25 million as a gift, not an investment, gift. Here, Dennis Prager, do propaganda for us. Tell everybody how great tax cuts are for the rich. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, tax cuts for the rich are great. Black people are terrible, yay, right? So Rubin is closer to the Prager camp. You look at his numbers, I know exactly what those numbers indicate. And he doesn't make anywhere near the money he would need to make to buy the, I think the $5 million house or whatever the hell he bought. It doesn't matter, it's not real. He's getting money to do propaganda. So these guys are now saying, go out there and tell people, we're done with Donald Trump. Have him be a glorified cheerleader, but the bankers have decided, the people who fund Dave Rubin have decided, it's time to move along, Donald. I don't think he's gonna take their advice.
It's not often that I find myself agreeing with Trump or ever, but if he's out there telling Republicans not to vote, you know what, go right ahead. Go for it. And I think that that's what's going to happen over him cheerleading for anybody else. I don't know what Rubin is thinking. It's like he didn't see Trump the last 4 years. Yeah, he is not going to cheerlead for anybody else. Hopefully, we don't get a DeSantis ticket like he's predicting. Yeah, I'm not sure where he's getting any of that from, but we'll see what happens with Trump.
It's probably as far as any conservative that's looking to continue the Trumpian way, it's a good plan. Yeah, have him still be the clown on the side that makes people laugh, and then have the DeSantis who's younger run with a black guy. And then, you know, we have this diversity ticket, and DeSantis is the clone of Trump, a younger one who isn't 80 years old almost. So it's not even a bad plan. It's what probably many conservatives want to happen. They just can't say it because Donald Trump will take your head off and everyone else around him will go, yep, let's watch that head roll because we know how they are. So it's a little bit of a risk to say something like that until you know that that's beginning to be the thing that's going downhill now. That being the strategy.
Guys, what is Dave Rubin thinking? The answer is always the same, nothing. He has no independent thought. He thinks whatever his donors tell him to think. So if he's out there talking against Trump, it's a guarantee that one of his funders told him to say that. There's no way that Dave Rubin is gonna go out there and be like, you know what, I'm ready to lose whatever little audience I have. I think Donald Trump should go back to being the court jester and be our security guard and keep his ego in check, okay, and do all the dirty work, but get none of the credit. First of all, even Dave Rubin isn't that dumb to think that Trump would do that, but I'm not positive, okay? But he certainly wouldn't naturally do that unless someone told him to do it, because he's potentially sacrificing his own audience. So that means the bankers are desperate to get rid of Trump. They created a Frankenstein. And he's now running amok. He's telling people not to vote for Republicans. Republicans get them tax cuts. He's trying to undermine democracy. They got a good thing going. Now there's an actual populist wing of the Republican Party going, hey, you know what? Maybe we shouldn't work for big business. Maybe our Mitch McConnell and other corporate Republicans are corrupt. Now that is a silver lining right there. That's actually true, right? There, I'm giving some right-wingers credit. You've noticed, yes, it's the corruption, stupid, right? And I say that to Democrats all the time. So the Dave Rubins of the world, paid by the rich folks, don't like you finding that out. put that populist genie back in a bottle, everybody go back to working for the bankers.
There's more energy coming out for that. Like, as information continues to flow through, there's more information and access to the way people see things happening. And you can still keep your conservative values. You can still wish that the government spent less. It doesn't under the people that you've elected, but maybe you can have a little bit closer to that reality if you actually ask and demand as citizens to get back what you deserve, because we pay into this. We own this. It's weird how we've detached ourselves from this, and suddenly conservatives are supposed to be the ones to be like, yeah, sure, government, just, you know, run roughshod over us and just continue to do what you want, but under the guise of saying it's only Democrats that want the government to run over us. The control that many people want the government to run over us with, under this thought of conservatism, just doesn't make any sense. And they're beginning to wake up. They gotta find a new route. And even that guy with Ken Griffin, he had to mention as an aside, oh, but his economic policies were great for America. That's always the go-to. That is the last part. As long as a Republican can continue to guarantee their money to come back into their pockets, he's still in good standing. I mean, he's a little crazy, he's off the rails, we have to deal with him. But as long as he comes back to giving us the money, we'll deal with him. But now they're tired. Oh my God, they're so tired of having to defend him, of having to go to parties and seeing his face there, or having people ask him, hey, how'd you support Trump for this long? And they gotta go, I kinda don't like him. Okay. It's hard.
Guys, you'll be able to tell if we're right or wrong. That's why we make predictions, et cetera, on the show, right? If you see now more politicians, because they're the other people like Prager and Rubin who are owned on the media, and almost all the Republican politicians are owned by the donors, the bankers, etc. If you see more and more of them coming out and saying, you know, Donald Trump, he's great, he's wonderful, of course, the standard ass kissing, but maybe he should, you know, let someone else do and be the elder statesman. You're gonna see that talking point more and more. And when you see it, then you'll be able to say, oh, they were right. The donors and the bankers are sending all of their lackeys to tell Trump, go get off the stage, get off the stage, right? And let me tell you, let me tell the bankers this. Don't waste your money on that. Ain't never gonna happen. Or you know what? Go ahead and waste your money. Okay, but it's not gonna happen. He's never gonna listen to that. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.